Hey friends, hope you're doing well. Today I'd like to show you a trick which overcomes limitation regarding the single selection slicer in Power BI. I'm gonna first show you the issue and then we figure out a solution for that. So let's say I have my report here. In this case, I only have one visual, but of course, if you have more than one, it works the same way. So let's say I want to create a slicer to slice here my sales figures. So let me go into my orders table here and then just choose here employees table here, and then choose one of the employees. So let's say, in this case, I want to see my employee names. Let me tick this option here, and then by default, I get a list, and I don't want to have it as a table. I want to have it as a slicer. So let me go in here and choose the slicer option. Now, so far, so good. Now, of course, the default behavior in Power BI is that we have a multi-select slicer, which means that I can select Elon, for instance, or Jeff. And if I hold my control key, I can choose two or even more of them. That works fine. So what if I'd like to actually change the slicer to a single select slicer? I can go into my slicer settings here, and then I can choose, instead of having the multi-select here, I can simply go with single select. So if I turn this on, you see that now I can only single select a name in here. So I cannot multi-select any names. This is a behavior which is, in certain cases, preferred, because you don't want to give the end consumer the option to select, for instance, two names in here. However, what is missing here is, what if you like to give the end user the option to either choose one of those employees or all? Which means that you cannot use two or three, you can either single select one or you can choose all. How do we do this? Well, it turns out that this is not that simple. Because if I untick the single select, then I have the option to enable this show select all. So if I turn this on, you see that there's a select all. So this works, and I can click here and can select all of them. This works fine. However, as soon as I choose the single select instead of the multi-select, so if I turn this on, you see that now the all is gone. And there is no option in here to enable the all again. So what do we do? For that, I have the following trick for you. We first go inside the data transformation, so in the Power Query Editor. And there it is. Let me zoom in. Here we go. We got here already our employees table. And now we create a helper column in here. We could also do it in Power BI and DAX with a calculate column, by the way. But in this case, I'm doing here in the editor. And all we do is we go to add column in here, go to custom column. And then we just specify here the custom column is just, let's call it select all. And then simply what's inside here is in quotes, select all, or whatever you want to name this. Next, we click OK. Then we can add this column in here. You can see that we can choose the data type, define a text in here. But you see that it just holds one value, which is select all. Next, we go to home and then we apply the change. So we get this new column for us in the data set. And just a second, and there it is. There's the select all. And now we can add this to our slicer. So we drag this into the slicer area in here. And of course, we need to change the order because currently the first level of the hierarchy is the employee name. So what we could do is if we go inside the slicer settings here and just drag this select all on top. And now you see that if I drag this down, we got here a select all option on top. And this allows us now, if I make this bigger here, I can now choose, for instance, Elon. I can click him, or I can select Jeff. You see that we can simply choose those. Or if we want to see everything, we just click on select all here, and you see that everything is now selected. And we can see the values for all. And this is a trick, actually. So this allows us, this hierarchy with the select all, to simply choose either one of those employees we have, or all of them together. And this overcomes the limitation which we currently have, because as you've seen in the current version of Power BI Desktop, there is no way to enable the single select and still have the select all option. And this was a use case which one of the clients required, and so that's the solution which I proposed, and that's maybe a solution which is interesting and helpful to you as well. So that's it for this trick. Hopefully you enjoyed it, try it out yourself, and as always, thanks so much for watching, and hopefully see you in the next video. Until then, best guys.